My name is Davis Mallory. I'm Slum Music. Was a country boy, grew up in the city though of California, you know what I'm saying? Grew up in a little small town of San Pedro, and that's when I started really developing and realizing who I am. My mom got me a keyboard and she got me two turntables, and I just ran with it, you know what I'm saying? And I never looked back. I've been doing music probably like over 30 years. So starting my business was like, I really founded the business in like in the 90s. That's when I thought I had my breaking point. You know, my name was building up. I was actually living in Long Beach. So during that time, I was making beats and I'm hearing Snoop Dogg and all their music and everybody music growing up. And then just happens to be, you know, some people that I know, some people he know, and it's all always some type of connect in the ear, so I can always hear what's the new music that's going on before it even comes out. So I developed Legitimate Crime Records. I wanted to start my own and do my own beats. It inspired me to see other people actually doing it, not just talking about it and say, yeah, I'm going to the studio and I'm going to do some rapping. And there's a time when you actually really see it done, and it opened up my eyes when I go to other people's studios and I see the artists who they work with, you know what I'm saying, that's big names today. And I say, man, I remember I was young going up over there just to listen, you know what I'm saying? And I go back home with my ideas and say, okay, this is how I want to do my music and generate my own creative sound. And that's when I created Slump.
Slump Music.
To be a G, but that's what they told me growing up in these streets. Living day by day by the hustle. I got a bush weight, just by the struggle. Hands on the muscle, streets through the gas. Trucks laced up, things wouldn't last. Chasing down the block, getting for his cash. But nah, I put that hole in my past. The streets raised me good, growing up as a G, you getting love and any good. Chris plus Asian, Latinos, all replicable, but I keep them on my team though. From the East Coast down to Sacramento, back to Diego to pick up my mango. Hit I-15 back to Las Vegas. Where my Slump at? Where my G's at? We on our block of war and we all across the map.
I met Slump in Las Vegas. We was actually doing some, it was a cool show. I can't remember exactly what show it was, but Slump, Bright. Him and his people were very bright when I first met Slump. He had a lot to offer to the table. So, and the sound was different. So, you know, and at first to me, it was like kind of mixed up, but I was intrigued enough to go and check Slump out. So that's what it was with Slump. And the rest is history, really.
Who in the industry influenced me? Oh, man. First of all, the one and only DJ Pooh. You know what I'm saying? Man, there's a lot of them, you know what I'm saying? Ice Cube, Dub C, you know what I'm saying? Crazy Tunes, RIP, you know what I'm saying? I love that producer. He was like one of my inspirations in producing music other than Battle Cat, you know what I'm saying? Because they were the two hottest producers that was out there other than Dre, you know what I'm saying? But everybody, you know, everybody's doing their own thing, you know what I'm saying? But their style of music is what caught minds because it got that swag slump to it, you know what I'm saying? You gotta have that little bounce to it, and I guess it's kind of like a West Coast thing, but you know what I'm saying? I like to mix it with East Coast beats too and just give it a whole new style, and that's why they call it slump. I grew up on the real old school hip hop, you know what I'm saying? KRS-One, you know what I'm saying? Eric B and Rakim. I remember Roxanne, EPMD, UTFO. That I can go on and on and on, you know what I'm saying? Music been my life, all my life. It changed my life when I was young, as a kid. There was a lot of things I could have been out there doing as a kid. I could have been out there slanging dope, pulling off robberies, whatever, you know what I'm saying? Once I got into music, something just touched me and kind of guided me away from all that right there, you know what I'm saying? It just looked at me and said, hey, man, that ain't for you right there. This is for you over here, you know what I'm saying? And I realized that it kept me out of a hell of a lot of trouble, you know what I'm saying? Sometimes you could think about it, damn, music probably done saved my life. I got introduced to the Las Vegas Block Report. It was through a lady that I know that worked for 89.5 FM, Oscat Radio. That was Erica Blue. And she was just having an interview with Bobby Brown. And then she ended up contacting me and asking me to send her some music. She was looking for something for Christmas time. And, you know, she wanted a producer or artist to actually come with a Christmas song. And I came with a song called 24 Hours to Christmas.
I got 24 hours to Christmas. Bought some presents and I spent a little change. I hope Santa got my wish list.
She introduced me to Tim Lewis. And he's the director and the founder of the Bay Area Las Vegas Block Report.
Met Slump, I say about 2 years ago. And from that, we created a really good communication for off the top. And I think that in doing business, that is a very important factor. And it was communication. And Slump was able to bring his music to the table and videos and artists from all over the country.
And I mean it with him, and I didn't even know what it really was. I mean, that was the first time I met up with him. I didn't know what the Block Report was. But then I said, man, this is right in my alley. This is something to do with music. Oh, top 10 video countdown? Oh, yeah, I'm with all this. You know what I'm saying? I'm pumped up. I'm stoked. He ended up giving me a contract. He gave me a contract for the Bay Area Las Vegas Block Report on Cox Cable TV. I didn't expect none of this, you know what I'm saying? But then I also looked at it, that how God works in his own way. And, you know, you meet everybody for a reason, you know what I'm saying? And he gave me a contract. And he asked me how much music did I have, and I said, I got a lot of music. He said, can you give me a catalog that got 100 songs on it? Actually, he said 50. So I said, yeah. So my thing was, instead of giving him 50, I gave him 100. After I gave him that, then he ended up giving me a 250K distribution contract. So damn, I was like, man, he just gave me a distribution contract with my own platform. So now I can distribute my own music.
chest plate. I'm coming fresh out the gates and I feel pain. You say crimes on the rise must be your mistake. So write your books and your palms, this is checkmate. These niggas think it's a game, write your chest plate. I'm coming fresh out the gates and I feel no pain. You say crimes on the rise must be your mistake. So write your books and your palms, this is checkmate. These niggas think it's a game, I'll be your darkest night. Can't you slipping in the fog at the midnight? From dusk till dawn, nigga, we can carry on. I'm a West Coast bound and you're fucking with my grumps. I'm all about my skrilla and scratch, you don't play with that. And you say you wanna send us back across the map. Hell yeah, nigga, you gonna catch me posted in the trap. As a matter of fact, you're on the pole, the hoes do that.